Ladies and gentlemen, get ready. Here he comes. Houston's one and only, Tommy Toon.
Let's get lost, lost in each other's arms. Let's get lost, let them send out alarms. And though they'll think us rather rude, let's tell the world we're in that crazy mood. Let's defrost in a romantic mist. Let's get crossed off everybody's list. To celebrate this night, we found each other. Ooh, let's get lost. This night we found each other. Who can resist such an evening as this? Ooh, let's get lost. Good evening and welcome to my Miller Outdoor Theater debut. I've played the palace and I've played the sticks. I can do shuffles and I can do kicks. I've taken my bows and I've taken my licks. Lord help me, I love it. I've danced for a fortune, I've danced for a buck. In front of the queen, on the back of the truck. Been up in the White House and down on my luck. I have had two big breaks in my career. One, when I fell down on stage and broke my foot. Yikes. And two, when I fell down on stage and broke my foot again. Double yikes. After the second break, the first call came from my spiritual mother, Carol Channing. She said, "Oh my goodness gracious heavens to Betsy, Tommy Toon, did you break that doggone foot again?" I said, "Yes and no, Carol Channing. It was the same exact bone, but the opposite foot." "Oh," she said, "perhaps that's God's way of giving you symmetry." I love the opening nights, the flashing lights. Fred Astaire attended the Broadway opening of the new Gershwin musical, My One and Only. He came backstage afterwards, looking exactly like Fred Astaire. And these are the first words my idol said to me. "You are a tall son of a bitch." And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the story of my life. But I've got the cart before the horse. Before I could experience the thrill of a Broadway opening, I had to get started, right? So let's back up to Texas, Houston, Texas. Houston, Texas in the 50s. You see, my father's great dream for me was the same as every Texas father's dream for their firstborn son. They wanted us all to leave Texas, go to New York, and dance in the chorus of a Broadway show. And I did. I arrived in Manhattan on St. Patrick's Day. They had painted a green stripe up and down the middle of Fifth Avenue. I considered it a lucky sign. There was also an audition that very day for boy dancers who sing. I went. Just like in a chorus line, from the back of the darkened theater came the voice.
Okay, guys, listen up. Sing the last 8 bars of your song. No more, no less. The last 8 bars.
Well, now, the last 8 bars of my song sounded like this. First, you gotta have heart. First, you gotta have heart. First, you gotta have heart. Excuse me, if I promised to stop, would it be okay if I sang the first 8 bars?
Jeez, there's always one. Okay, go on.
You gotta have heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start.
Why did you stop?
That was 8 bars.
Sing the rest.
You gotta have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing's half as bad as it may appear. Wait till next year and hope. When your luck is bad and zero, get your chin up off the floor. Mister, you can be a hero. You can open any door. There's nothing to it but to do it. You gotta have heart. Miles and miles and miles of heart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart. First, you gotta have heart. First, you gotta have heart. First, you gotta have heart. Once again, the voice in the dark.
How tall are you, son?
5'17¾".
Are you a member of Actors Equity?
Yes, sir.
Good. Report to this theater Monday morning at 10 a.m. for rehearsals. Oh, and don't be late.
First day in New York. First audition. I got the job singing and dancing in the chorus, and I have been in show business ever since. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's not how you go, it's how you land. If you start at the top, you're certain to drop. You've got to watch your timing. Better begin by climbing up, up, up the ladder. If you're going to last, you can't take it fast, man. Nobody starts a winner. Give me a slow beginner. Easy does it. Conserve your fine endurance. Easy does it. Cause that's your life insurance. While you are young, take it rung after rung after rung. After rung. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's not how you go, it's how you land. 100-to-1 shot, they call him a klutz. Can outrun the favorite, all it needs is the guts. Your final return will not diminish. And you can be the cream of the crop. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. And you're gonna finish on top. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. And you're gonna finish on top. Thank you. The name of the show tonight is Taps, Tunes, and Tall Tales. Taps, Tunes, and Tall Tales, all performed down there on the world's tiniest tap stage. Wish me luck. Let's take it nice and easy. It's gonna be so easy for us to fall in love. Hey baby, watch your hurry. Relax and don't you worry. We're gonna fall in love. We're on the road to romance, that's safe to say, and we'll make all the stops along the way. Hey, the problem now, of course, is to simply hold your horses. To rush would be a crime. Nice and easy does it every time. I'm sitting up here on this ladder so y'all can get a gander at my latest pair of Tommy Tune saddle taps by Capizio. Soon to be on sale in Target. You will notice there's a silver tap on the toe and the heel of each of them. Now the toe tap makes a kind of pinging sound, and the heel is more of a thump thump. So when the choreographic moments occur tonight, and they will, I invite you to tune in with your ears to the rhythms and listen up. We're on the road to romance, that's safe to say, and we'll make all the stops along the way. Hey, the problem now, of course, is to simply hold your horses. To rush would be a crime. Nice and easy does it. Nice and easy does it. Nice and easy does it every time. Ladies and gentlemen, on drums tonight, from New York City, Mr. John Meyers. And on bass, from Brooklyn, New York, Marc Schmied. And on piano, from San Francisco, the man who has been with me for 40 of my 55 years in show business, my music director, Mr. Michael Biagi. I'd like to sup with my baby tonight and raise a cup to my baby tonight. I'd like to sup with my baby tonight, play the pup with my baby tonight, but I ain't up to my baby tonight, cause it's too darn hot.
It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot.
I'd like to fool with my baby tonight and play it cool with my baby tonight. I'd like to fool with my baby tonight, break every rule with my baby tonight. But Pillow, you'll be my baby tonight, cause it's too darn hot. According to the Kinsey Report, every average man you know much prefers to play his favorite sport when the temperature is low. When the thermometer goes way up and the weather is a sizzling hot, Mr. Gob for his squab, a Marine for his queen, a GI for his cutie pie is not.
Why not?
Because it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. I'd like to hug with my baby tonight, cut a rug with my baby tonight, but baby, I'd be loved tonight, cause it's too darn hot.
Yes, it's too darn hot, it's too darn hot, it's too darn hot.
Okay, here's the deal. Very early on, I learned that to be in show business is to be on tour. The great legends of the theater, Alfred Lunt and Lynn Fontanne, taught Carol Channing about touring when she was just getting started. Carol Channing taught me. And these are her exact words. Tommy tune. If it is your desire to pursue a career in the theatrical arts, you must tour your shows to the capitals of the world. I said, name one. She said, Minneapolis. So I toured. Not just concerts like tonight, but the shows, the big shows. The shows that I directed and choreographed sometimes appeared in on Broadway. Shows like, well, The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. That was my first big hit. And then I did a version of Fellini's 8 and a Half. We called it 9, the musical. That was a big one. And then it was The Grand Hotel, the musical, based on the MGM film. That was a big one. And then the Will Rogers Follies, and on and on and on and on. We would play these shows on Broadway for a couple of seasons, and then send them out across the country, sometimes across the world. Why, I even played the Soviet Union when the Iron Curtain was still down. There I was in Moscow, one of the capitals of the world. Center stage in the Hall of Columns, tap dancing up a storm on the exact spot where they had laid out Lenin. He didn't seem to mind. But the reception at the end of the show was disconcerting. See, the Soviets clap in unison like this. Do it with me. Do it with me so I can give you the idea. Don't get faster. Think Soviet. Now stamp your feet under your chairs, because that's what they also do. Now it gets louder and faster and louder and faster. 5,000 Russians going like this. I was terrified. You just never know what to expect in a foreign country. Speaking of Texas. Well, we are, and proud of it. I was in Dallas not long ago, and I needed to get to Paris. So I called the local office of the famous airline. This is how they answered. Bonjour, Air France. Can I help you? I had one wonderful year on the road with Anne Reinking in a really snazzy production of Bye Bye Birdie. Gene Sachs directed, Annie and I choreographed, and I played Albert to her Rosie. I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I'd feel is several hours older. Lilacs or lilies, any bloom you please, all that they did was make me shrug or sneeze. But now I love each blossom that I see, for a lovely little rose loves me. Now my life is rosy, since I found my Rosie, with a girl like Rosie, how could I be blue? Hand in hand we'll mosey, me and little Rosie. Life would be so cozy in a cottage made for two. Oh, I once heard a poem that goes, a rose is a rose is a rose. Well, I don't agree, take it from me. There's one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my Rosie. I'm so glad she chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me. Returning to Manhattan after an extensive tour, there is always a crash. an emotional crash. They loved you in London, but now you're back home, unemployed, and yet still yearning for that loving feeling that you get on stage. So what do? You look for it off stage, and I did. And I got lucky, and I found it. Don't ask me just how it happened. I wish I knew. I can't believe that it happened, but still it's true. Hide your heart from sight. Lock your dreams at night. It could happen to you. Don't count stars, for you might stumble. Someone drops a sigh, and down you tumble. Keep an eye on spring. Run when church bells ring. It could happen. All I did was wonder how your arms would be, and it happened to me. But I've learned that just as your long-running, successful show eventually closes, so too can a seemingly successful, long-running relationship. As Rex Harrison said in My Fair Lady, damn, damn, damn. All day long before my eyes, I have these visions of you. I shouldn't I mustn't, but I do. Can't get out of this mood. Can't get over this feeling. Can't get out of this mood. Last night, your lips were too appealing. The thrill should have been all gone by today. In the usual way. But it's only your arms I'm out of. Can't get out of this dream. What a fool to dream of you. 'Twasn't part of my scheme to sigh and tell you that I love you. But I'm saying it, I'm playing it dumb. Can't get out of this mood. Heartbreak, here I come. Can't get out of this mood. Starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face. I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. On the roof, it's peaceful as can be. And there the world below can't bother me. When I come home feeling tired and beat, I go up where the air is fresh and sweet. I get ahead of the hustle and crowd and all that rat race noise down in the street. On the roof, the only place I know, where you just have to wish to make it so. After living on the island of Manhattan for 55 years, uptown, downtown, east side, west side, mid, I've been very peripatetic. Look it up. I recently found, acquired, and moved into what I consider to be at last my spiritual home. It's this tall, eccentric tower that sits atop this big apartment building. So it is, as the song says, literally up on the roof. I have a 360 of the whole city. And from my kitchen window, I can look down directly into the apartment of Greta Garbo. She doesn't live there anymore. Right smack dab in the middle of town, I found a paradise that's trouble-proof. And if this world starts getting you down, there's room enough for two. Up on the roof. Thank you. got a little rhythm, a rhythm, a rhythm that pitter pats through my brain. So darn persistent, the day isn't distant that it'll drive me insane. Comes in the morning without any warning and hangs around me all day. I'll have to sneak up to it someday and speak up to it. I hope it listens when I say, fascinating rhythm, you got me on the go. Fascinating rhythm, I'm so excited. Want the flip to make him, the neighbors want to know why I'm always shaking, just like the flipper. Each morning I get up with the sun, start a hopping, never stopping, to find that night no work has been done. I know that once it didn't matter, but now you're doing wrong when you start to patter. I'm so unhappy. Won't you take the day off, decide to run along somewhere far away off and make it snappy. Oh, how I long to be the man I used to be. Fascinating rhythm, won't you stop picking on me. Stop picking on me. Thank you. ...2015... was a banner year for me. On June 7th... at the Radio City Music Hall in New York City, I was given my 10th Tony Award. So now, I am officially 10-time Tony Award-winning Tall Tapping Texan Tommy Toon. I'm crazy for alliteration. But thinking about that 10th Tony reminds me of my first Tony Award. It was for Best Featured Actor in a Musical. The musical was called Seesaw, and it was a game changer. Suddenly, people you wouldn't dream of, people I wouldn't dream of, were inviting me places. For instance, the great artist Salvador Dali invited me to his suite at the St. Regis for lunch. Would you like to hear about it?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Well, my friend Pat asked, told me that Salvador Dali loved candied violets. So I traipsed all over the island of Manhattan looking for candied violets. I found them finally at a store called Takashimaya. It's on Fifth Avenue. Do you remember it? Yeah, it's a great store. It's not there anymore. Today it's a Forever 21. I can't relate. Anyway, the big day arrived. I got all gussied up, parcel in hand, knocked on the door, was ushered in, and there was the great man displayed on a chaise longue wearing a multicolored caftan. Actually, it was more of a muumuu. Well, now, I had thought it would be a nice gesture, a nice international gesture to address the great artist in his native tongue. So I practiced up on my cowboy Spanish, you know, I'm pretty good. And I let forth with a flowery salutation in Espanol. He answered me in French. I know about 4 words in French, but the one that came to mind was merde. Not to be deterred, I sallied back with something about the weather. Once again, he answered me in French. Third time's a charm, Tommy Tune, do it. Spanish, French. And I said, Monsieur Dolly, I am speaking to you in Spanish because you're a Spaniard. You're speaking to me in French. I'm not a Frenchman, I'm a Texan. I am so confused. He popped up from the couch and said, congratulations, Monsieur Tune. Confusion is where it's at. It was very surreal. Vamanos. Someone to hold me tight, that would be very nice. Someone to love me right, that would be very nice. Someone to understand each little dream in me. Someone to take my hand, to be a team with me. So nice. Life would be so nice if one day I'd find someone who would take my hand and samba through life with me. Stay with me right or wrong. Someone to sing to me some little samba song. Someone to take my heart and be a part of me. Someone who's ready to give love a start with me. So nice. Life would be so nice. So nice. Should it be you and me? I could see that would be nice. This is a cold number. It's too darn hot. A five, a six, a five, six. I've got sand in my shoes. The tide's drifting near me, and life seems so dreary to me. I've got sand in my shoes. I've found there's no true love, and I'm just as blue as the sea. Once I built castles in the air, happiness was there. Then a certain party ceased to care. The castles fell and broke the spell. So there's sand in my shoes. A cold breeze is blowing, and I'm feeling low as can be. Once I built castles in the air, happiness was there. Then a certain party ceased to care. So I smile, why not smile? My tears get me nowhere. I know where I stand. I've got sand in my shoes. Thank you. I have no idea what's next. Oh, yeah. Let me have a drink of water first. Branch water, good old Texas branch water. Now, those mesmerizing syncopations were passed down for me by my all-time favorite tap dancing partner, the late, great Charles Honey Coles. I want to tell you about Charles Honey Coles. He was tall, slender, handsome, a gentleman of color, grace, style, a master of the soft shoe, and a chick magnet. Oh, he was debonair and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he would dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the ladies say, he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and hardly made a sound, but I've noticed in all his reviews that when he took his pal to the crowd and the crown, the crowd went crazy and the house came down. When Honey wore his very soft shoes, late in the second act of the Broadway show My One and Only, Charles Honey Coles and I sang and danced a duet to the title song. Opening night at the St. James Theater, we stopped the show cold. We could not go on with the scene. We could not go on with the show. The applause was beyond deafening. It was like a tsunami of applause. It just kept coming. It just kept coming. It'd start to fade, and then it'd come again. And it just kept coming. Well, I was gobsmacked. Charles Honey Coles, being my senior, I whispered to him, what should we do? He just grinned up at me and said, let's do it again. Well, now, Charles Honey Coles was from vaudeville, and I think they did that kind of thing in vaudeville. If the show, if their act was a big hit, they went into the wings, the people were still clapping, the theater manager would send them back out, and what did they have to do? They only had their act, so they'd do their act again. But this was not vaudeville. This was a legitimate musicale opening night on the Great White Way. Critics in place, star-studded crowd. I gulped, walked downstage, broke the fourth wall, leaned down to our conductor in the pit, Jack Lee, and I said, take it again from the top. He said, what? I said, take it again from the top of the dance. So we did the whole thing again, and we entered the annals of Broadway lore. Nothing quite like that had ever happened before and hasn't happened since. Charles Honey Coles and I both won Tony Awards for our performances in that show. Yes. And I won for Best Actor. Charles Honey Coles won for Best Supporting Actor. I'm telling you, I was more thrilled and excited for him than I was for me. He had not been given the breaks that I've been given for a lot of reasons. But anyway, there he was that night at the Tonys, spiffed out in his tuxedo, looking resplendent with his trophy in hand. He was 76 years old at the time. And he said, "Well, this just goes to prove if you stick around long enough, something's bound to happen." Funny, 76 doesn't seem that old to me. Into a cabaret one fatal day, a little songbird flew. Found it so very gay, he thought he'd stay just to get a bird's eye view. When he heard the jazz band playing, he was happy as a lark. To each movement he kept swaying, and he stayed till after dark. Then back to the land he knew, thrill through and through, he sailed on in the air. Called all the other birds, and in these words started gurgling then and there. "I'm a little jazz bird, and I'm telling you to be one too. For a little jazz bird is in heaven when he's singing blue. I say it with regret, but you're out of date. You ain't heard nothing yet till you syncopate." Jazz bird is the only kind of bird. A little jazz bird is the only kind of bird to be." Once upon a time, there was a young and impressionable moth who set his heart on a certain star. He told his mother about this. She counseled him to set his heart on a lamp instead. "Stars aren't the thing to hang around," she said. "Lamps are the thing to hang around." "That way you get somewhere," said the moth's father. "You don't get anywhere chasing stars." But the moth would not heed the advice of either parent, and every evening at dusk, he would start flying toward the star. And every morning at dawn, he would crawl back home, worn out with his vain endeavor. One day, his father said to him, "Boy, it has been months since you burned a wing, and it looks to me as if you were never going to. All your brothers have been badly burned flying around street lamps, and all your sisters have been terribly singed flying around house lamps. Now go out there and get yourself scorched." The moth left his father's house, but he did not fly around street lamps. He went right on trying to reach that star, which was 4 1/3 light years, or 25 trillion miles away. The moth thought it was just caught on the top branches of an elm. He never did reach that star. But he went right on trying, night after night. And when he was a very, very old moth, he began to think that he really had reached that star, and he went around saying so. This brought him a deep and lasting pleasure, and he lived to a great old age. His parents and his brothers and sisters had all been burned to death when they were quite young. Moral: who flies afar from the sphere of our sorrow is here today and here tomorrow. It's good, isn't it great? Isn't it grand? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays? There's luck everywhere, love everywhere, laughs everywhere, life everywhere, joy everywhere nowadays. I first heard this song in the original production by Bob Fosse of Chicago, the musical. It was introduced by one of our great stars, Gwen Verdon. I miss Gwen Verdon. Broadway is just not the same without her. Gwen Verdon inducted me into the Theater Hall of Fame. And afterwards at the dinner, she told me something that she believed. She said that she believed that dancers die two deaths. One when they stop living, of course, but an earlier one when they stop dancing. It's a long, long while from May to December, but the days grow short when you reach September, when the autumn weather turns the leaves to flame. One hasn't got time waiting game. Summer has come and passed. The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends. Though my father's come to pass, 50 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September ends. Here comes the rain again, falling from the stars, drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are. As my memory rests, but never forgets what I've lost, wake me up, wake me up. All the days dwindle down to a precious few. September, I'll spend with you these golden years. I'll spend with you. Raindrops keep falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun, and I said I didn't like the way he got things done, sleeping on the job. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, they sent to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I know I'll never kick the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. What a life. And through it all, I have been blessed with a plethora of beautiful dancing partners. Line them up. They would be a chorus line of leading ladies. Let me remember a few of them for you. Cheetah Rivera, Gwen Verdon, Anne Reinke, Tina Turner. Yeah. Barbara Streisand. Sandy Duncan, Lucy Arnaz, Lauren Bacall, a piece of work. Marge Champion, Drew Barrymore when she was 11, Joan Rivers, Phyllis Diller. I taught her to hustle. But the one partnership that Broadway audiences really seemed cotton to was when I teamed up with my one and only Twiggy. When my life is through and the angels ask me to recall the thrill of them all, then I shall tell them I remember. It only happens when I dance with you. That trip to heaven till the dance is through. With no one else do the heavens seem quite so near. Why does it happen, dear? Only with you. Two cheeks together can be so divine, but only when those cheeks are yours and mine. I've danced with dozens of others the whole night through, but the thrill that comes with spring, when anything can happen, that only happens with you. But the road to Broadway for the show My One and Only was not an easy ride. During our out-of-town tryout in Boston, nothing worked. The show would not come together. We could not get through it. Then there was a fire backstage at the Colonial Theater. Then the producers fired the original director. Then they came to me and pressured me to take over the direction of the whole kit and caboodle. I said, hold on. I'm already starring in the show. I'm already choreographing the show. And I'm teaching Twiggy how to tap dance. Too many hats. They said, you take over the direction of the show or we're closing it right here in Boston. I said, okay. Within 24 hours, this latest news had reached the Big Apple. Twiggy and I ended up on the cover of New York Magazine. There we were in our taps, top hats and tails, up in the air, happy as two clams. Underneath the caption read, Twiggy and Tommy Toon fall on their funny faces. Mared. They all laughed at Christopher Columbus when he said the world was round. They all laughed when Edison recorded sound. They all laughed at Wilbur and his brother when they said that man could fly. They told Marconi his wireless was a phony. It's the same old cry. They laughed at me wanting you. Said I was reaching for the moon. But oh, you came through. Now they'll have to change their tune. The odds were 100 to 1 against me. The world thought the heights were too high to climb. But people from Missouri never incensed me. Oh, I wasn't a bit concerned, for from history I had learned how many, many times the worm had turned. They all laughed at Christopher Columbus. No, did I do that again? I meant to do that. Stop. I must collect myself. What's the lyric? What's the lyric? No, the lyric I missed. Oh, let's just go there. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. They all laughed at Rockefeller Center. Now they're fighting to get in. They all laughed at Whitney and his cotton gin. I'm so embarrassed. They all laughed at Fulton and his steamboat, Hershey and his chocolate bar. They told Marconi no, his port and his Lizzie kept the laughers busy. That's how people are. They laughed at me wanting you, said it would be hello, goodbye. But oh, you came through, now they're eating humble pie. They all said we'd never get together, they laughed at us and how. But ha ha ha, who's got the last laugh now? Opened on Broadway. We fixed the show. It was a hit, a big hit. Clive Barnes said, Twiggy is a revelation. Walter Kerr wrote, Twiggy and Tommy Toon are the hottest thing on four legs. I love that one. We had a great run. We made a lot of people happy. But as I said before, even your most successful shows eventually close. But it was particularly bittersweet for both Twiggy and me when that final Broadway curtain rang down on my one and only. Our romance won't end on a sorrowful note, though by tomorrow you're gone. The song has ended, but as the songwriter wrote, the melody lingers on. They may take you from me, I'll miss your fond caress. Though they may take you from me, I'll still possess the way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. No, no, they can't take that away from me, the way your smile just beams, the way you sing off key, the way you haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again on the bumpy road to love. Still, I'll always, always keep the memory of the way you hold your knife, the way we dance till 3, the way you changed my life. No, no, they can't take that away from me. No, they can't take that away from me. my sweet embrace of old. The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. They can't take that away from me. Tell a story, a true story. Sit down, just one more little thing. I want to tell you this story. It's a true story. I've never told it anywhere before, and it will only work here, in this city, with you. Here's the story. A few years ago, I received my star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. It was a big deal. When they do the ceremony, they put a red carpet down on all the other stars. So only your star is showing. There's a hole in the red carpet, and there's your star. You don't see any other stars. And the band plays as they're speechifying. And it was great and wonderful and splendid, and I loved it. But that night, all by myself, I came back to visit my star. And I also wanted to know who my next-door neighbors were. The carpets were gone, and lo and behold, next to me on my left was the star of John Houston. And over here on the right was the star of Texas Guinan. Houston, Texas. Feels like home to me. See, I had to tell it here. They wouldn't clap in Dallas. Steve Martin said, telling your life story on stage is the ego's last stand. And so it is. I have left out so much. The summer stock years, the Catskills years, the off-Broadway years, the Broadway years, I pretty much covered them, the Hollywood years, oh, the Hollywood years, yeah. I was dancing in the chorus of a Broadway show. I was discovered, flown out to Hollywood, screen tested, and ended up with a 7-year contract with 20th Century Fox. I was immediately enrolled in talent school. I was taught to fence. I was sent to jungle dancing class. Oh, you know who was with me in that jungle dancing class was that guy with the Hawaiian shirt and the mustache, Tom Selleck. He was very good at jungle dancing. Then I was loaned out by the studio to NBC to perform and choreograph, assistant choreographer I was, my official title, for the Dean Martin show. I did 3 seasons on the Dean Martin show. Now, that was a change, that was a big game changer too, because I worked with, well, everyone you can imagine, Ella Fitzgerald, Peggy Lee, Sammy Davis Jr., Lena Horne, Frank Sinatra, and Dean himself, who was the greatest natural talent I've ever encountered in my whole career. He just made it look so easy. He had a little bit of help, but not much. That was mostly an act, mostly. I did a number on the show, because I guessed it on the show all the time. I did a number with Orson Welles and Zero Mostel. It was a song called Triplets. We look like 2 buttons and a zipper. Back on the Fox lot, I landed a really plum role in the movie of Hello, Dolly, directed by Gene Kelly. Now, Gene Kelly gave me the best direction I have ever received. On the set between takes, he came up to me and said, "Tommy, dance better." The London years. I went over to London to make the movie of The Boyfriend, directed by Ken Russell, and that's when I met Twiggy. The Rome years. I went over to Rome to make a movie called Mimi Bluet Fiori del Mio Giardino. I played opposite the biggest star in the Italian cinema at that time, and her name was, yeah, Monica Vitti. Oh my God, she was, you know her. Che bella questa donna, che bella. It was this movie, it was epic. It was molto Italiano, molto artistico, molto nudo. Hush up, don't tell mama. Then, oh, Vegas was next. 900 performances at the MGM Grand, starring in this ginormous $45 million spectacle called Effects. Now, I never thought of myself as a Vegas kind of guy. I mean, my idea of gambling is taking a walk through Central Park whistling a show tune. I had one wonderful evening with the greatest actor of this past century, Sir Laurence Olivier. Over dinner, among other things, we discuss the nature of the performing arts. Why we get up on a stage and do what we do. Is it just extreme narcissism? Is it an addiction to the creative process? Is it some wanton desire to make everybody happy? Why this curious need to entertain? Why? Finally, Sir Laurence just looked me in the eye and said, "My dear boy, it's all of it, simply an expression of love." And so it is. I've played the palace, and I've played the sticks. I can do shuffles, and I can do kicks. I've taken my bows, and I've taken my licks. Lord help me, I love it. I've danced for a fortune, I've danced for a buck, in front of the queen, on the back of a truck. Been up in the White House, and down on my luck. Lord help me, I love it. I love the one-night stands, the three-piece bands, the dressing room without a sink. I love the opening night, the flashing lights, and those Vegas hecklers who've had too much to drink. I've worked with the famous when I was unknown, been in with the in crowd and out on my own. I've played to full houses, I've sat by the phone, but traveling here or traveling there, from McAllen to Memphis, I'll play anywhere, 'cause Lord help me, I love it. Thank you, Houston, for being here tonight. I had a great time. Every time we say goodbye, I die a little. Every time we say goodbye, I wonder why a little. Why the gods above me, who must be in the know, think so little of me, they allow you to go. When you're there, there's such an air of spring about it. I can hear a lark somewhere begin to sing about it. There's no love song finer, but how strange the change from major to minor. Every time we say goodbye, every single time we say goodbye.